पर्सनल इशू, इट कैन नॉट बी थोपोड ऑन अस एंड मेड एन एक्सक्यूज फॉर एनीवन एल्स टू बिहेव बैडली. दैट्स व्हाई डीलिंग विद सेक्स एंड डिस्कसिंग सेक्स इज एज इम्पॉर्टेंट एज डिस्कसिंग अ लॉट ऑफ अदर थिंग्स, बिकॉज दिस होल प्रोहिबिशन हैज मेड इट ओके फॉर अस टू बी मोर गिल्टी अबाउट आवर लाइफ. A lot of beautiful lipstick riddle smiles there. I'd like to start with Alankrita. Alankrita, give us a peek under the burqa. What is the primary emotion you're feeling right now?
Well, I'm really, really excited because and very relieved because it's been a very long journey to get the film out, and I can't wait for people in India to finally watch the film.
And we can't wait either. Next up, I would like to ask Ekta Kapoor. You've bagged films like LSD, Urta Punjab, Dirty Picture. You're not shy to toe the line. But with this specific picture, personally, why did you choose this picture?
Because this picture doesn't toe the line. And frankly, I saw the film with a lot of thought process. Okay, it'll be a bit pretentious. It'll be arty, 11 awards. Great. And then I saw this very, very stark and entertaining film. And here it was, standing there, staring me in the face and saying, do you have the guts to take me on? I think I never had a more honest internal conversation with myself than I had after I saw this film. And I think a lot of women will experience the same thing. We're so scared to feel that it's now become second nature to us to be shy about even our own simplest sexual fantasies, our own simplest desires. It's like it's not allowed. And this film had this, it stared me in the face and asked me a question as a woman, that as a producer, you'll make a financial decision. But as a woman, it's time you make a decision from the heart. And I did.
That's a beautiful, beautiful reply. I'd like to go on to Ratna Pathak Shah. Do you think we're right in calling this film a movement?
A movement? I think we may be a little premature. We might turn out to be right, but we are a bit premature. Anyway, let's not load the film down with words such as life-changing, movement, new wave, etc., etc. All these things labels can be very hard to live with. What I saw when I saw the film was that here is an extremely interesting, extremely sensitive, funny film. I enjoyed watching it, and I think the audience will too.
I hope so too. Konkana ma'am, why do you think it's important for millennials to watch this film, the younger kids?
I think that, you know, a lot of us today take for granted the kinds of struggles that women have gone through just in the last 100 years. We just take it for granted. Like, women were not allowed to vote, we were not allowed to own property, we were considered property. We don't know how much progress we have just made in the last 100 years. We just take it for granted. And of course, there's a long way to go still, but I think that this film is one of those films which definitely it stands by what it says. And it speaks very honestly about women and their inner lives. And it gives you a very authentic experience of that, of the inner lives of these four women. And I think that people will especially young people, I think they'll really respond to the authenticity and the integrity with which this story is told.
That's beautiful. Moving on to Ahana. Why do you think it's important for a woman to own her sexuality?
Because if a man can own it so easily, I don't see why a woman can't. We've just been doing so many things behind closed doors for years, and nobody talks about it. And till the ban came about, as Alankrita was just talking about it with us a few minutes ago, we didn't realize that, you know, that as a woman, we really don't have rights like the way men do. Not only in India, but also all across the globe. You may think that, you know, everybody in America or a Japan or a Sweden or a Finland, they are so out there, they're so progressive, but no. a woman is still where she is supposed to be in all these countries. So India alone is not fighting this battle. I think the whole world is fighting this battle, especially America right now, who used to think they're so progressive. So I actually saw a different side to the film. So it's very important right now for women to own their sexuality and be out there, because we really deserve it.
That is so true. And now for the final question before I open it up to everybody else, I'd like to ask, the final question is to Plabita. Can you tell us a little about the support you've been getting for this film? Because it has been overwhelming from what I hear.
Yeah, actually, I think none of us had ever thought that it's going to be like this. So I first watched the film at the Tokyo International Film Festival. And even over there, we got like a standing ovation. And you know how people could relate to it? Women were coming up to us and telling us how much they loved it. I mean, there were some people who came for the second screening as well, you know, to watch it again. And then I was really happy and I was like, wow, this film is, you know, going to do good. And then we come here and the whole censorship thing happens and I was like so sad. But then the way everyone supported, it was amazing. Like, I was like, that is when it was like, okay, we have to get out there. And, you know, everyone needs to watch this film.
Definitely, more power to the cause. I now would like to open out the questions to the press over here. If anyone would like to ask a question, you can raise your hand. I'll pass on the microphone.
ये कि जब भी इस फिल्म का जिक्र हो रहा है, CBFC का जिक्र होता है, पहलाज निहलानी का जिक्र होता है, तो अभी एक मोमेंट बन चुका है और एक पोस्टर भी ऐसा आया जिससे सभी बेहद खुश हैं भारत में बहुत ज़्यादा. आप क्या कहना चाहेंगी और CBFC के रुख के बारे में क्या कहना चाहेंगी आप?
मेरा कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है CBFC से. मेरा प्रॉब्लम पूरे समाज से है जो एक पॉइंट पे आके इसी बात को अपनी तरीके से कहता है. तो CBFC इज एक्चुअली अ मिररिंग सोसाइटी. बहुत छोटा हम इशू कर देंगे अगर हम CBFC के बारे में बना देंगे इस पिक्चर को. ये बहुत बड़ा इशू है. आप नॉर्मली अगर किसी लड़की से बात करेंगे तो आप उससे 5 इंसिडेंसेस ऐसे पता कर लेंगे जो सात दिन में हुए हैं. एक साल में तो 5-10 तो निकलेंगे ही, जहाँ उसको अपने औरत होने पर दे शी हैज़ हैड टू प्रूव हरसेल्फ अ लिटिल हार्डर, मे बी इन अ मेल डोमिनेटेड वर्क प्लेस एट टाइम्स विद अ सर्टन अमाउंट ऑफ हैविंग टू बी कम अक्रॉस एज अ स्मार्टर वुमन इफ शी इज गुड लुकिंग. मतलब देर आर सो मेनी, शी इज लर्न्ड कॉम्बैट फ्रॉम अ वेरी यंग एज. और आप ये जो उंगली है ना, ये लिपस्टिक जो है, ये उस समाज पर है जो हमें बाहर आने नहीं दे रहा, हमें अपनी आवाज़ को दबाने की कुप्पे मजबूर कर रहा है. तो इट्स नॉट अबाउट CBFC, इट्स अबाउट एवरी, एंड इट्स अबाउट एन आइडियोलॉजी, इट्स नॉट अबाउट मेन अगेन. प्लीज, आई एम गोइंग टू डू अ कैंपेन कॉल्ड लिपस्टिक फॉर मेन, बिकॉज आज नो इट इज बिकॉज देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ मेन हु मेड अस द वुमेन वी आर, लाइक माई फादर, एंड देर लॉट्स ऑफ वुमेन हु इंसिस्ट दैट देर इज अ सन बॉर्न and put their daughter-in-laws through various children and abortions. So it's not about women and men, it's about ideology. So
yeah, it's about patriarchy.
Yeah, it's about patriarchy.
To put it in a simple word, it is patriarchy. And it is something that, like Ahana said, women are battling all over the world. You know, I grew up at a time when my mom and people of her generation had fought to be where they were. I stand on their shoulders. I got my education. I got the kind of freedom and life that they were not able to have. And the sad thing is, I can't pass it on to my daughter. How sad is that? In one generation, we have given up all these advantages and we are moving backward rapidly. So it's patriarchy. It's an incomplete project, this project of dealing with patriarchy. And we all have to accept that we have a role to play, men and women. Very important to understand that it's not a single gender issue.
Alankrita, film kai samarohon mein ja chuki, hamari aapse un dino hi baat hui thi jab issue chal rahe the certificate ke. Abhi kitne relaxed hain and 21st July ke liye kis tarike se taiyar hain?
Ab to I'm having I can't believe it's happening actually. I was so used to this thing of like it's not going to happen, and I think it's really, really wonderful that Ekta came on board, because I think that has really like made the whole release like so much fun. And you know that at least we're coming out with a lot of strength. So I feel after battling so much,
I would have hated to have a very small kind of struggling to release kind of an energy with the film. So I feel like the film really deserves a wider audience. So I'm very, very happy that there is a way of reaching out to a wider audience. So I'm excited and I want everyone to come to cinemas on 21st July.
Hi, Shivangi this side from Aaj Tak here. So mera sawal aap sabhi se hai ki jis tarah se ye film hai women empowerment ki baat karta hai ya jo women's ki mang hai ya demand hai jo ichhaye hain uske bare mein baat karta hai kya aap logo ko lagta hai ki sex ek mudda hai jahan par hum auraton ki ichhaye ya auratein lad rahi hain kya sex ke mudde se hi hum is cheez ko prove kar sakte hain ya koi aur mudda lekar hum film nahi bana sakte the
I think before I ask anyone else to answer, I would really like to answer this question. I think the side.
Sorry to interrupt. अगर आप ये जवाब हिंदी में देंगी तो बहुत अच्छा.
तो मुझे क्या लगता है कि औरत की जो body होती है ना, वो सबसे पहला area होता है conflict का. And therefore, I feel that many issues about women finding themselves, finding freedom, are definitely related to how much. Agency and control they have over their own bodies. So that's what I feel. So I don't feel that kuch disconnect hai between other issues and all of that. But this is a story about four women. So it's not even that,
I would say sex ek bahut chota ansh hai in char auraton ki zindagiyon ka aur unki kahaniyon ka. Zarur important ansh hai, jaisa ki sab ki zindagi mein hota hai. लेकिन सिर्फ ये ही एक मसला है ऐसा मैं नहीं कहना चाहूँगी. अनफॉर्चुनेटली ये जो सारे तमाशे हुए हैं और जिस तरह की पब्लिसिटी हमको मिली है उसकी वजह से ऐसा लगता है कि ये सिर्फ एक गंदी पिक्चर है. ऑन द कॉन्ट्ररी जो बंदे ये पिक्चर गंदी पिक्चर सोच करके आएंगे ना तो बहुत दुखी होंगे.
आई एक्चुअली बिलीव सेक्स ना ऐसी चीज है जो हमने बहुत सालों से व्हेन इट कम्स टू वुमेन छुपाई है. अनफॉर्चुनेटली आपको बोला जाता है आप अपने आप को ढको क्योंकि फिर उस आदमी का भेड़िया बनना अलाउड है. बिकॉज यू नो व्हाट, आपने अपना शोल्डर दिखा दिया. अरे मेरा शोल्डर है, आप भेड़िए बने. इट्स लाइक सो दैट इज अ वेरी बिग प्रॉब्लम. हम वी आर नॉट बीइंग एबल टू डिस्क्रिमिनेट बिटवीन सेक्सुअल इंटेंशंस और सेक्स एंड सेक्सुअल क्राइम. सेक्सुअल क्राइम इज अ प्रॉब्लम. सेक्स इफ इट्स कंसेंशुअल बिटवीन टू पीपल इज नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम. And unfortunately, the more we are dabbing this topic, we are making more and more women responsible for any kind of sexual desire that is raised in them or in a man. Frankly, really, guys, we have, I mean, I would like to say, like, it's a world where God has given us a body and it feels. And as long as we are in control, as long as we deal in anything that's consensual, morality should be our personal issue. It cannot be thopoed on us and made an excuse for anyone else to behave badly. That's why dealing with sex and discussing sex is as important as discussing a lot of other things. Because this whole prohibition has made it okay for us to be more guilty about our legs being shown. I mean, we've had so many photos of women come out, actresses, whose shoulder was shown. Oh, you know what, a malfunction happened and it went all over the place. Come on, man. There are many malfunctions I'll show you of men, but no one covers them. And it's time we decide to discuss sex like adults without playing it up. If you see the movie, it is not at one point vicarious or it's not at one point exploitative, but it's never running away from the issue. It speaks as it is. That's why it stares you in the eye.
Alankrita, hi. A lot of reports say that the poster is directed at the CBFC. Did you intend it to be that way?
I think Ekta already answered that question, but just to repeat, no, not at all, because the poster is directed at the system of patriarchy, which actually oppresses women. And it's really about being rebellious and fun and wanting to do our own thing, and the world can go to hell.
Hi, Megha here from Republic TV. My question is for both Alankrita and Ekta. I have two questions. One, what is the distribution plan of this movie when we have three other movies releasing on the same date? And secondly, an elderly woman recently from Meghalaya was asked to leave from a golf club because of her dress, and she was wearing a traditional Khasi dress, which is considered to be a maid uniform. So what do you have to talk about this particular issue wherein, you know, how long for us to end chauvinism and...
How long? Does anyone have an answer? Patapat bata do, mujhko bhi batao. I'm dying to know how long. I've been waiting for so many years now. I want to know.
I've entered a temple with a half pant and I'm told two other men who've entered with like same length of pants, it's okay, but I'm not allowed to show my this part of the leg also, which is like, it happens all the time. I mean, and clearly this is a situation that we have to constantly combat. That's what I say, it happens to us every day. And your shoulder showing here, up, decently dressed nahi hai. Wo decent word kaise aa jata hai, mujhe pata nahi chalta. As far as the release goes, we're planning 400, 500 screens. We'll push it as much. And we are hoping to create as much noise. This is a film that is very close to my heart. And I will do everything in my power to give it the widest release, the rest.
Thank you.
Alankrita, recently Pehlaj Nilani said that, you know, if he got a lack of votes, he would allow the word intercourse in Jab Harry Met Sejal. Did you wish he'd started some voting system for your film as well?
I didn't know that these new kind of laws can be made at any time. I thought that we are following the 1952 Cinematograph Act. If there's been some change, I have not been informed. I don't know. Has there been some sort of change? I have no idea.
Ekta, you of course are a very commercially successful producer. A film like this with an A certificate and even your trailer's A certificate. So, you know, it can't be shown on TV and you'll have restrictions. You know, even playing the trailer out. Was there ever a consideration before backing the film?
Do I look like it made a difference to me? In my whole life, I've done things because I believe in it. And sometimes I've been wrong. Sometimes I've been horribly right. Sometimes I've been terribly wrong. I've been panned, but I've lived life according to my own rules. And since I've been backed by my family, I've been able to do that. And I hope I get a chance to get more and more women to do that for the next generation. I hope I can help a lot more women to live the life they want, like I have been able to.
Hi Ratna, here, Soumya from Times Now. Firstly, the trailer looks amazing, congratulations on that. And my question is, it is not very, usually we don't see, women of all ages expressing their feelings and desires. I mean, and even when it is about the young girls, and this movie does it without any age bars. So what do you have to say about that?
About time that people figured out that, you know, we are not dead. Just because you happen to have a few white hair doesn't mean you are dead. So, yeah, I mean, people have desires all through their lives, emotional, sexual, all kinds of desires. And the fact that this kind of a story could be told and was even thought of, I don't think it would have been possible 4 years ago, 5 years ago. The fact that Alankrita did and that we are here today with this film means that something is going right. So we are getting to tell different kinds of stories.
Alankrita, my question goes to you. Why the trailer has been so hard-hitting?
Well, the reason that the trailer has been so hard-hitting is that I've had a very hard-hitting kind of journey. And I think I'm done with the niceties. We've been very soft and kind and all of that. But I think I'm really done with that. Because, you know, we had a very warm, like, graphic image that we had used earlier when we had for the international festivals and all of that. But I think time's really up on that. We applied for the census certificate at the end of December. We got it in our hands on the 3rd of June, and on the 5th we announced the release. So it took me almost 6 months to get a film certified. I think I'm allowed to come out with a trailer that's hard-hitting, because also I feel that what happens to the characters in the film is exactly what happened to the film. It was like, if women want to express themselves, they should just be told to shut up and stay at home and not show their film in theaters. So I think that there's a real parallel between what women experience and what actually the film experienced. And that's the reason we came out with this trailer. And also I think that it's really important for people to go out into the theater to watch this film, because otherwise it's like, what was that whole battle for? And as citizens of India, are we really interested in listening to women's stories? Are we interested in freedom of expression? And I should think that the fact that this film is releasing is not just about, you know, like the people behind the film, but the fact that it's important that the film is managing to
21st.
Hi, Ekta, this is Priyanka. Hi. I wanted to know that do you sometimes feel guilty of reinforcing stereotypes around women through TV shows?
Never. Never, because if you see the kind of women I've shown on television, they just wear a sari. They may have OTT makeup, but OTT and the level of makeup is your own personal desire again. But nowhere in any of my shows have any of the women touched their husband's feet, called them Parmeshwar. We have tackled marital rape, domestic violence. It's the only problem is that they wear saris and they look traditional. And you know what? For a lot of women, the battles we take on TV are real. So if you go through this Boston research that was carried out for television in India between 2001 and 2005, and it's an independent research, one of the most valued researches worldwide, they will tell you that a lot of women in Indian homes who never had a stand in family matters, actually after Tulsi and Parvati, were allowed to discuss or take part in family decisions, because if they could, why can't they? So clearly there have been different battles. Some are very, very strong and very, very loud, and some of them have to be, you see, if I show a woman wearing different clothes, speaking a different language, I may not be able to have an identification with the woman because she feels there's a different woman's story. Today, when you actually have somebody who is probably of a certain mindset, she speaks your language, and she goes and takes that battle on, you feel more and more attached to that battle. As a woman, it's a small thing, but in none of our shows, we have tried to show any kind of patriarchy. In fact, we've made very, very strong women characters, and our men are pretty much there for, which a lot of people say, for the...
What I want to ask is, why didn't you just go ahead and just put it up on your platform of Alt Balaji and just give Pehlaj Nilani the lipstick? In that sense, you know, that you could bypass.
Because it's not about Pehlaj Nilani, sir. I mean, why are we constantly coming back to this question? I am not, it's like, this is not, you are trivializing my battle, my friend. Our battle, your battle. This is so much more. This is about you going back to your own home. It's not about taking on the CBFC. I, in fact, want to say this. I have no problem with Pehlaji. I respect him. He has a point of view, and I may or may not agree, but that's not the conversation here. At this present moment, we're discussing a society and ideology, and she, like ma'am said, patriarchy. It's got nothing to do with that at all.
Institution of
course. Yes, yes.
Alankrita? When you sort of, you know, decided to make the film and you have the subject at hand, were you apprehensive that, you know, you might not have actors on board? What was the journey like when you sort of, you know, chanced upon the script? And tell us about that, because, you know, we're only talking about what has happened post the controversy. Give us an insight into, you know, how you sort of went about it in the beginning.
Well, for me, it was just a story about four ordinary women and their secret lives. So I wasn't overthinking that, oh, now who's going to? Because for me, everything that they do is very natural. And there was nothing out of the ordinary in that sense. Because it was just like an honest kind of a story. So I wasn't very worried about how I'm going to get actors. And I was very fortunate that, I got the actors that I did. And I don't think they ever questioned. They read the script and we had a discussion and they were immediately on board. So I don't think there was any sort of fear on their part. The rest, maybe Konkana can tell you, and Ratna and everybody.
It's so rare, and you know, she didn't chance upon the script. She worked on the script for so long. And it's such a pleasure to read such a well-written script. Not that it doesn't happen as often as it should, that one reads such a beautifully written script that rings so true and is so authentic to a certain experience, you know.
And nuanced. You know, it's not a poster kind of thing where you're just
it's
making
not shill
a statement.
Propaganda.
Yeah. At all. It's you empathize with these women, you experience their lives with them, you understand what they're going through or why they're going through it, you know, and it feels very authentic and very true.
At least for my character to be able to read Usha and Shireen's parts, I was like, oh yeah, this also can happen. You may not realize that there are women of Usha's age who would experience a sexual desire. It's so unheard of, and it's something that nobody ever discusses or ever talks about. So yeah, insightful.
Casting रत्ना और कोंकणा को तो मतलब स्क्रिप्ट भेजा था मैंने और फिर उनसे बातचीत की और उनकी कास्टिंग हो गई. प्लबिता और आहना के जो पार्ट्स थे उनके लिए हमारे कास्टिंग डायरेक्टर्स हैं श्रुति महाजन और पराग मेहता. उन्होंने बहुत बहुत हार्डवर्क किया और ऑलमोस्ट कितनी सारी एक्ट्रेसेस का ऑडिशन हुआ एंड फाइनली वी डिसाइडेड ऑन बोथ ऑफ देम. तो इट वाज अ वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग प्रोसेस. इट वाज अ लॉन्ग प्रोसेस टू कास्ट द अदर्स बट विद रत्ना एंड कोको इट वाज लाइक स्ट्रेट अवे.
अलंकृता अलंकृता या माय क्वेश्चन इज बिफोर अच्छा ओके सॉरी शी आस्क्ड यू समथिंग कैन आई गो
एक्चुअली हम लोगों को इतना एहसास नहीं था कि हम लोग अलग तरह की फिल्म बनाने जा रहे हैं. ये सब चीज़ें बाद में सूझती हैं. फिल्म बनाते वक्त इतना ही मालूम होता है कि सुबह 8 बजे उठ करके मेकअप लगा के पहुंचना है हमको टाइम से जगह पे. और डेफिनेटली इंटरेस्टिंग सिचुएशन थी. भोपाल में शूटिंग कर रहे थे, लोकेशन पे कर रहे थे, इसलिए उस माहौल का, उस एटमोसफियर का को अपने आप में आत्मसात करना बहुत आसान रहा. वहाँ के लोगों के साथ मिलते थे और वहाँ जो लोग रहते थे उनके साथ भी काफ़ी चर्चा वगैरह होती थी. तो ज़बान, क्योंकि सब लोगों को थोड़ी बहुत ज़बान भी बदलनी पड़ी थी, वहाँ की बोली इस्तेमाल की गई है. सो यस, इस तरह से काफ़ी सारा रिहर्सल हुआ, शूटिंग से पहले भी, शूटिंग के दौरान भी, सीन करने से पहले भी हम लोग एक रात पहले रिहर्स करते थे. और एक बहुत ही ट्रस्टिंग और क्या कहते हैं, हेल्पफुल वातावरण सेट पे था, क्योंकि इस तरह के सीन्स करना काफ़ी मुश्किल है इमोशनली भी. तो इसलिए एक अच्छा और सपोर्टिव वातावरण सेट पे होना बहुत आवश्यक है.
यस, बेसिकली माय क्वेश्चन इज द मूवी वाज यू नो शोन अक्रॉस द ग्लोब, यू नो अ लॉट ऑफ कंट्रीज एंड यू नो अ लॉट ऑफ अक्लॉज एंड अवार्ड्स यू गाइस गॉट. Were you expecting कि इंडिया आएंगे तो ऐसा रिएक्शन होगा where you know it will be completely like you know banned, not given a certification. In fact, पहले भी ऐसी movies आज like for example I'll just give the example of Dirty Picture. It's an excellent film. उसके time पे भी बहुत you know questions उठे थे लेकिन फिर भी film release हुई you know with certain cuts maybe here and there. But in lipstick under my burqa को बिल्कुल उन लोगों ने you know certification देने के लिए मना कर दिया. Were you expecting something like that or what was your thinking then?
No, not at all. I mean, in my head, I wasn't making something that is so blasphemous or anything. So I think it was just a story. It's a story about four ordinary women and their secret lives. And the fact that such a small, I mean, just such a, that kind of a story can threaten the patriarchal system is something I realized later.
Konkin, I would like to ask you about your character. What is it all about? Can I, what all brief did you get it from Ankita?
My character's name is Shireen Aslam. And she's a woman who has 3 children and she manages, you know, her household and her life as per the expectations from her. But, she has certain restrictions, constraints in her life, which she accepts. But she manages, but she also has her inner desires, her inner ambitions, her inner, you know, whatever, things that she wants to fulfill. And she has to find innovative ways to work around the loopholes of what is allowed and what is not allowed and still manage to get, you know, whatever these small dreams are and how to accomplish these small dreams while managing so many other things, while fulfilling so many roles, while being so vulnerable and yet being so strong at the same time.
So, same question.
My character is called Leela and she's a beautician and she's again battling a same desire. She wants to do something with her life. And I'm sure that happens with most girls in India who are from smaller towns. I'm from Lucknow. Agar aaj main Lucknow mein hoti, toh shayad mere 3 bachche hote, main scooter pe hoti apne husband ke saath. Meri shaadi ho gayi hoti. Lekin kyunki main ek Bombay jaise shahar mein hoon, mere paas opportunities hain. Kyunki Bombay aisa shahar hai jo aapko opportunities bhi deta hai. She's again from a small town. And she wants to explore a world out there. Usko Delhi jana hai. She wants to make a life. So she has a desire and she wants to fulfill it. And she'll probably go to any extent to fulfill that.
एकता जी
अरे हेलो हेलो सारी कहानी बता रहे पिक्चर की फॉरगेट इट ना 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 ये बहुत चालाक है कोई आदमी ना 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 इस तरह से तो सारी पता चल जाएगी कहानी ऐसे नहीं पिक्चर जाके देखो टिकट खरीदो
एकता जी मेरा सवाल आपसे है 1 जुलाई से GST लागू होने जा रहा है और गाइस
लिपस्टिक के कितने परसेंट का GST है
मैम आपसे मैं पूछना चाहता हूँ कि जैसे कि सैनिटरी नैपकिन की हम बात करते हैं तो सिर्फ हमारे इंडिया में 12% यूज किया जाता है और यहाँ पे मैं सबसे गंभीर मुद्दा है कि 88% वेमेन यूज नहीं करती है वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की जो रिपोर्ट है जो लीव्स यूज किया जाता है क्लोथ यूज किया जाता है तभी भी हमारी गवर्नमेंट है 12% टैक्स लगा रही है सैनिटरी नैपकिन में कॉन्डम की बात करें तो टैक्स फ्री होता है लेकिन ये जो सैनिटरी नैपकिन है बहुत नेसेसिटी होता है तो आपको लगता है इससे भी टैक्स फ्री होना चाहिए प्रोडक्ट को व्हाट इज योर ओपिनियन
डेफिनेटली होना चाहिए बट एक्चुअली दिस इज नॉट द राइट प्लेटफॉर्म टू टॉक अबाउट दिस बिकॉज़ ऑनेस्टली आई एम नॉट दैट वेल रेड अबाउट व्हाट रियली इज बीइंग टैक्स्ड एंड हाउ मच बट आई डेफिनेटली ऑन दिस इशू आई हैव हर्ड अ लॉट अबाउट I personally think a necessity of a woman cannot be taxed you know be it a choice be it a need be it a desire
I just want to say one thing, which is that notice how so many of us giggled at the term sanitary napkin.
You know, one thing I must say that we have to stop as women using words like auntie aaye, you know, have that day of the month. The more used to we get, and I've started using this in office, even though it's with men, they better live with it. I have my periods. Because it's nothing to be shy or embarrassed about. So I think this is a... She's right. It's just everyone sniggers.
And if you don't have any control over a body function, how can that be considered to be taxed under luxury as a luxury good? It's not like you're voluntarily saying, okay, I won't put on the AC tonight. It's not the same thing. And I don't know why adults are laughing when such an important question is being raised. No. I mean, we're talking about toilet paper, toothbrush, toothpaste, we're talking about sanitary napkins, condoms, sanitary napkins. It's like we're in school.
You know, but embarrassing. I work with an educational NGO, so I know what it's like. 10, 15 years ago, when we first started work, we were doing some stuff which had to do with the way in which the body develops. And you have no idea how the teachers responded. They were appalled. They said, no, 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 chi, 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 never, 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 never. 10 years down the line, the same teachers come up to us and say, we can't thank you enough. You know, this has given us a way to talk about something that nobody wants to talk about and it's so important to talk about. Would you put a child inside a swimming pool without teaching that child how to swim? But you put a child out into the world to produce others like itself, right? Without any training. So it's time for us to stop behaving like ostriches, get our heads out of the sand and look at the world.
Get our heads out. That's a wonderful note to end with. These are women who have left their mark. You saw our trailer that definitely left their mark. And now to leave a lipstick mark. Ladies, if you could put on some lipstick. We have with us the... Oh, you already have some. Yeah. So let's leave your personal mark on this board. This is the Leave Your Mark board. It's going to be traveling around the country. So go out there, get your mark, your lipstick marks on that board. We will give you a pen. You can write a message. So that board's going to be getting a lot of action. Really jealous about that board, aren't we all?